Bro, the character arc from when you started YouTube to now is insane, and I'm eating it up. The growth, girl. I've been a follower since the Curly Penny Tomboy days, and it makes me so happy to see the confidence. I feel like I watched you grow over the years into who you are today by always watching your YouTube videos. One of the top comments that I always receive is about how much I have changed. And it's true, I have changed a lot. But I'm still crusty where it counts. I chopped off my hair, I started wearing makeup. But most of everything, I've changed my style by a lot. I used to wear like baggy men's clothing slash like Krusty the Clown core. It was a vibe. I popped off on occasion. But y'all, I get so bored so easily. So I've experimented with a lot of different styles and silhouettes and colors. And over time, I have taken notes of what flatters me the most and what makes me feel most confident. So today, I'm gonna be sharing with y'all how I reinvented myself and my style and how you too can reinvent yourself and your style. But first, okay, you gotta reinvent your mind. Now listen up, cause some of y'all really need to hear this, okay? Y'all gonna hear today. Y'all gonna hear me speak today. Stop caring what people think. All humans are flawed by nature and everybody has insecurities. While you're afraid that that person is judging you, they're also afraid that you're judging them. If they're gonna judge you, they might as well judge you while you're living your best life and doing your own thing. Never ever ask yourself, are they gonna like me? No, no, no. Ask yourself, do I even like them? Do I even want them to like me? You gotta put those clear boundaries in your life on people, on things that are draining you, that are demolishing your self-worth. Surround yourself with things and people that fill you full of life, that build you up, that encourage you, that give you a breath for life. But that starts with you loving and respecting yourself first. Once you have addressed and removed these mental blocks from your life, you can continue to live your life fully, enjoying every moment, to have the courage to be who you want to be. And that's where the fun part comes in, experimenting with fashion. So this is what my closet used to look like. I had two closets full of clothing that was just exploding and spilling out. I had so much clothes that the freaking rack broke in half. We legit thought someone was robbing us in the middle of the night, but no, it was just the closet breaking. So I was like, you know what? No, gotta try something new. So I was really inspired by the idea of a capsule wardrobe. A capsule wardrobe has very carefully selected individual pieces, so you have the minimal amount of clothing with the maximum amount of possibilities. It reduces clutter, it saves money, and you have so much more outfits that match and more combinations since everything already cross matches. So this is my closet now. It actually has taken me over a year of thrifting to put this together, and I'm so freaking proud of it, and I love every single piece. So here's how I transform my closet in 4 steps. Number one, find your faves. Start by finding your favorite pieces of clothing that you wear the most. Analyze it. Why do you wear so much? Look at the color, look at the texture, look at the silhouette, look at the fabric, look at the style. And now start matching other pieces in your closet to this piece. And it's gonna help you start practicing that cross combination. Now do this process with every favorite piece of clothing that you have. This will also help you separate the clothing that you actually wear, that you actually like, that contributes to your wardrobe, from the clothing that is literally just taking up space and collecting dust. Like this sweater. I wear it so freaking much. It is my favorite like sweater top right now. And I actually got this from ThredUp, which is the sponsor of today's video. ThredUp is an online thrift store as well as a consignment shop. Everything is secondhand, quality checked, with fast shipping and discounted prices. Like this shirt right here was $17, $47 cheaper than retail price. I also got this other DKNY hoodie for $17, $47 cheaper than the retail price. And they always have sales going on. They always have stuff that's under $20, $15, under $10. But they also have more premium brands as well, like Madewell, Free People, Levi's. And a lot of these items are eligible for return and refund. You can use my code Penny for 30% off your first order with free shipping. That's actually a good deal, and I'm gonna see if I can use that myself. And you can check that down below in the description box. I linked it for you. Again, my code Penny, 30% off with free shipping. Number two. Closet clean out. Now that you have found those pieces in your closet that you don't really wear, that are taking up space, that are collecting dust, kind of like what I did to my brain cells after I graduated college, you know? Don't get rid of it. You're gonna grab that clothes, right? You're gonna put it in a bag. Now you're gonna put that bag somewhere out of sight, but safe. You could put it in another closet in the house, under your bed, or in the back of your car. And you're gonna keep that bag there for 6 months. There may be some moments where you think, oh snap, you know, I actually really wanted this shirt because it goes with this, right? And you can always go back to that bag, pull out that item, and put it back in your closet. Whatever you don't use in the next 6 months, donate it, because it's clear that you don't need it. And before you do donate it, consider upcycling it. Maybe there's something you can do. You can dye it, you can cut it, you can do something to it so you can wear it and keep it. Pro tip, look at the color palette. Look at your closet and the pieces that you kept, and look at the color palette. Having a color palette is a really easy way to ensure that most of the things in your closet already cross combine, so it's a lot easier to create outfits. This is my personal color palette. I like to call it Caca Couture. You know, I got some little caquita shades, some earth tones going on here. But there are so many different color palettes on the internet, dude. Like, you just Google a bunch and see which one you like the best for yourself. Number three, shop intentionally. I used to be a mindless shopper, okay? I would buy things because, ooh, that's cute. Ooh, that's on sale. Ooh, I don't have anything like this. Oh my gosh. That dreaded sentence, I don't have anything like this. That's the exact trap that I fell into. And that's exactly how we end up in that trap of, I have nothing to wear because nothing cross matches. Do you see the loop here? Do you see what I'm painting here? Do you see the Picasso? You see what I'm saying? Obviously, you can do whatever you want, but I do recommend that you create like this list of items, right? And slowly, with patience, over time, you can start marking the items off of this list. The more patient you are with this process, the more you're going to score very special items that are like, wow, like this, I love this. I'm going to wear the crap out of this. And before you consider buying something new, try buying it secondhand. You can try a thrift store, or you can try an online thrift store like ThredUp. Pro tip number two, if you're not really sure what to buy, you don't even know what your style is, y'all, listen, Pinterest. Pinterest has helped me so much to develop my personal style. They have such amazing boards and aesthetics and styles. One of my biggest tips as well that I tell people is to actually draw inspiration from your favorite cartoon or movie characters. So some characters that really inspire my style is Kate from the movie Hackers, Nancy from the movie The Craft, and Tim LaFleur from the movie Senseless. So you can just Google, you know, these cartoon or these movie characters, look at their style, look at their wardrobe, and see what you would like to try on yourself. And then you can go and try to find similar items. And my fourth and final tip, be patient. Enjoy the process. This is not gonna happen overnight. Do not go and do a crazy haul. Like I mentioned before, my wardrobe took over a year to curate and put together. But because I shop with so much patience and intention, I ended up with a wardrobe where I love every single piece. Literally every piece in my closet, I have an emotional attachment to. It's actually kind of sad. Now I actually wear my clothes. Sometimes I feel like I wear certain pieces way too much, but honestly, then I realize that's just a lie. That's a consumerist lie, that you just have to wear something once and throw it away. Okay, no, I'm going to wear my things until they have holes. Cover those holes with cool patches, and then once it rips, I'll just crop it and turn it into something else, because that is what it means to shop with intention. Plus, the clothes will look cooler and grungier that way anyways. And that is how I reinvented my style. I hope that you found some of these tips helpful. I've been wanting to make a lot more content on my capsule wardrobe, as well as upcycling a lot of my stuff to make it just like cooler. You know what I mean? So let me know if you would like to see that. Again, use my code Penny for 30% off your first order with free shipping from ThredUp. It's seriously, it's a great deal, and I have great clothes and I love it. I'm personally gonna keep using the app. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.